Hello there and welcome to this video. This is going to be a quick guide on how to set up BizHawk, the emulator, together with the SotN Rando Tools by Tarek Zello in order to play the Castlevania Symphony of the Night randomizer. For this we're going to need a couple things, namely the emulator itself, so you're going to need 2.6 or higher. Let's download the Windows version right here. There we go. And we're also going to download the tools, so let's just release SotN Rando Tools. Here we go. I'm going to leave links for both the tools and BizHawk down in the description below, so don't worry. Now, we're also going to need a couple more things, namely the game, the disk image, and the BIOS file. Unfortunately, I cannot provide you with these with any of these because it would be considered piracy, so you're going to have to find these on your own. I've already gone ahead and extracted the emulator into a folder called Biz, so we're going to go ahead and boot up the exe. And here we go, that was easy enough. The problem is, if we try to boot up a game right now, it's not going to work because we don't have the firmware files to make the PSX core run. So, I can show you. If I do this, it's going to say, you're missing the firmware. Well, that's an easy fix. We're going to go ahead and move our BIOS into the firmware folder. Let's copy here. There we go. Now let's start the emulator again. Open the ROM. Well, what do you know? It works! Okay, there's a few options that you're going to have to change. You're going to have to enable the second memory card. So for this, you're going to go over to PSX, then Control MM Card Settings, and you're going to check this box. Then you're also going to go over to Options, and you're going to switch from Pixel Pro mode to Tweet Metnafen. Just like so. It's going to ask you to reboot the emulator, so let's go ahead and do that. Okay, there we go. Now, some other options you're going to have to tweak are the controller, so use your personal bindings. I play on keyboard and I use the arrows and these buttons. I know most people play on pad, so if you have a controller, you're going to have to disable the auto tab in order to bind both the analog stick and the D-pad to the same input. So I press that's up on the D-pad and up on the stick. Going to be down, down, left on the D-pad, left on the stick, right on the D-pad, right on the stick, select, start, and so on and so forth. Let's go ahead and save that. Okay. Now, something else you're going to want to change are the hotkeys, because this is a TAS emulator, which means it's going to have lots of hotkeys for TASing. If you just tap escape, you're going to clear all of these bindings. There we go. Maybe the save states. Let's get rid of this, get rid of this. Task Studio, let's get rid of everything just in case. And there we go. I'm simply going to bind fast forward to speed up the boot up of the console. So let's continue. And well, now we can play the game normally. The problem is we still don't have a clear file. So that means we're not going to be able to skip the cutscenes. That is an easy fix again, so we're going to go ahead and close the emulator. We're going to move over to the PSX folder, and here in Save RAM is where the memory card is stored. So we're going to place our clear file here. Place the file, there we go. And now we should be able to skip cutscenes, dialogues, and to get access to the duplicator, and so on. And let's go ahead and load up the flash ROM. Speed up. And here we are. So now we do have access to a clear file. It says right there, clear. Another thing you really want to change is the display options. So for this, you're going to go over to config, display, And personally, what I use is a custom aspect ratio of 7:6. Okay, this makes the game look really nice and increase the window size to threefold. This is the size I normally use to play. Okay, so there we go. Let's close this. And now what we want is to be able to use TeleXelot's tools. For this, we're going to copy this folder here. Okay, we're going to replace the external tools. And now there we have them. So we're going to boot up the game again. Let's load the ROM. Now we're going to start the tools by going over to the Tools tab, External Tool, and SotN Randomizer Tools. Now here you're going to get a warning that this may or may not harm your PC, but believe me, it's not going to harm your PC. It might hurt your feelings though. I'm going to say yes, and here are the tools. We're mostly interested in the tracker, so we're going to go over to the tracker section. There's a few options we can change. Personally, I like all relics to be shown. And I don't like it to be on top, so I'm going to disable this. And then it is very important that you keep the save replays option checked, because if you don't save your replay, whichever race you do will not count. Okay, now we can launch the tracker. There we go, let's scale it down a little bit. There we go. As soon as I hit start now, it's going to detect both the seed and the preset. Since this is the vanilla game file, well, it's going to say, you know, whatever we have here. So, input Richter to play as Richter Belmont. However, we are interested in a randomized file. So, for this, I'm going to go ahead and open another ROM, a ROM that I've previously randomized. And let's make this quicker. There we go. Start the tools. Use the tracker. And, well, we've got our casual seed right there. So, a good way to know whether you've got the vanilla game file or a randomized bin is to, you know, have a look at this text or at the tracker itself. With this being said, that's pretty much all for this video. If you've got any questions, make sure to leave a comment down below. I'll try to get back to you as soon as I can. You're going to find useful links down in the description, as I said before. So yeah, happy gaming everyone. Peace out. Goodbye.